ओके करो।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डिस्कस फर्स्ट टू फोर प्रोज लेसन्स फ्रॉम फ्लेमिंगो। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट लेसन, लेसन नंबर 5, इंडिगो। अबाउट द ऑथर, इन दिस सम इंफॉर्मेशन इट इज गिवन, लुईस फिशर 1896-1970 वॉज बॉर्न इन फिलाडेल्फिया। ही सर्व एज अ वॉलंटियर इन द ब्रिटिश आर्मी बिटवीन 1918-1920। हियर सम मोर इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट हिम, इट इज गिवन एज हियर, फिशर मेड अ करियर as a journalist and wrote for the New York Times, the Saturday Review, and for European and Asian publications. He was also a member of the faculty at Princeton University. The following is an excerpt from his book, The Life of Mahatma Gandhi. The book has been reviewed as one of the best books ever written on Gandhi by Times Educational Supplement. So here, what is the major thing that you can get it here? The life of Mahatma Gandhi. This book and this lesson is Indigo. It is taken from that book. The excerpt from that book, it is taken from we have to highlight that is The Life of Mahatma Gandhi. That book you can read, you can refer, and you will get more knowledge about the Mahatma Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi's philosophy. So here everybody can understand situations, different situations in history especially. So here some leaders, they have given their contribution. The national leaders, they try to focus on all aspects that how can they help, especially the poor people or those who are in need. So here, understanding is important. They used to communicate directly with the people, and that was their very important plus point. Nowadays also, their philosophy, their views, their thoughts, we are always reading, we are thinking on that. Some of you, we are implementing also, especially the non-violence, because nowadays we have to think about the world peace, and that world peace, it is important, because after Second World War everybody understood the importance of peace, importance of mutual understanding, importance of self introspection, and there should not be differences among us, maybe due to the language barriers, maybe due to the caste, creed, race, so many things. So we must be equal, we must treat everyone with equality. And suppose those who are rich, they should not humiliate the poor people, they should help them. Or there must be a humanity approach whenever you are taking any person for your work. Or suppose you will assign some work to any person, the person who is poor, so that person should not feel humiliated while doing the work. So understanding of the fact, understanding of the situation, it is equally important. Some leaders, they are understanding situation, they're doing study of that situation. And then after doing study, they are thinking to proceed. And most of them, they succeed in the different fields. So here, author is talking about the Mahatma Gandhi and Mahatma Gandhi's philosophy, Mahatma Gandhi's discipline, nature. So all things we can understand. Here, from the beginning, here, while reading the lesson, what you have to keep in mind that some poor peasants or poor people, how poor people, they got the problem because of the landlords, or they suffered a lot because of the landlords' wrong decisions, or purposefully they have taken the decisions. And especially some, they were illiterate. So when the opponent party is illiterate and you are literate, your attitude should not be like this, that you will deceive them. So this type of nature to deceive someone or to cheat someone and take out their money or take out their lands, or we will not give them benefit, like this approach, it is not good approach for the any person. So keep in mind that we will not have such type of approach in future. Suppose you would become the leader, so here some leadership qualities discussed, humanity approach it is discussed. When you will become the actual active part, or when you will have the active part in the decision making, when you will get the right to vote, means after now 12th, everyone you will get. So you have to decide, or you have to take part in this democracy, and then only we can strengthen the democracy. So all that democratic principles, whichever it is mentioned in the constitution, so all that democratic principles, or whatever the things it is mentioned in the preamble, we have to follow that, think on all the points, means equality, freedom, expression, so many things here it is mentioned. And we have to empower others on that. We have to create awareness among everyone, and you can become one of the important, means youth can change everything. So here you can take leading as a student, using student forum, or there are so many platforms, NSS or NCC platform, so many different platforms are there, or you can form NGO, or you can work in, means local government also, you can develop the rural area. So here Gandhiji always used to think about the rural area development, the means basically our economy, it is depend on the farming. So most of the farmers now they are facing the problem, so you can help them, and that would be the great help to the country, or country's economy will sustain due to that. Or you can guide them for different business, small business, or you can lead such type of people, those who are still in the problem, and give them justice. And while preparing any task, or whenever you will take any task, don't think for limited period of time. Think in such a way that up to the last, everyone should have benefit from that. Sometime what happens, some they are criticizing others because they are getting publicity. Sometime it happens that if any leader is famous, then if we will criticize that leaders, then we are automatically getting publicity. So like that it should not happen. Suppose you are trying to help someone, then attitude should be selfless. You should work with honesty. And sometimes problems will come, hurdles will come, that ordeals will be there. But that ordeals will teach you how to fight. Because sometimes the opponent party, opponent team, or those who are in the power may ridicule you, may interrupt you, or sometimes they may use the power against you and they may stop doing your good work. But don't stop. Take the help of the law, because there are so many laws or constitution, and according to that constitution, according to the rules and regulations, you can help so many people. Means now you can work on Right to Education Act. There are so many still illiterate in our India. In Maharashtra also there are so many children, they are not studying. Their parents are not aware about that. Or for the sake of just money, they are sending their children as a child labor. Or some they are just doing the begging work. So like that situations are still there. Means why I am talking about this specially? Because after the death of the Gandhiji, after the death of so many national leaders, still we have not taken care of the poor people. We are not having that sensitivity about them. And means we should think about each and every aspect and we should train them. Suppose some, they may not understand your attitude, your intention, but surely some people, they will observe you, they will observe your intention, and if there would be positive intention, then what you can do? You can think about that and you can help them, especially the youth. You take the youth, because nowadays youth, they are not having certain goal. So you lead and you give them certain goal, give them some plans and take follow up of that and create nice atmosphere. So you will also develop the leadership qualities. So here, after reading this lesson, learning outcomes, very important thing, that is what you will learn from this lesson, what message you will take from this lesson. So here the qualities, leadership qualities, here we have to develop. And while thinking about the development, sustainable development is important. Sometimes we are just thinking about one problem. Okay, this problem it is solved, then everything it is solved. No, the root of the problem is important. So in this lesson, the same thing here we can observe. Means here law may give you the judgment. Okay, you are free, now you will get all the rights. But after getting that judgment, after means from any committee or any mission, here any commission, it will be formed and that commission will give the report, or you may get the justice from the court. But after that, is everything changing? No. The root of the problem is the illiteracy. Root of the problem is lack of awareness in the field of hygiene, social hygiene, means the health care. Nowadays also, in this COVID-19 phase, lockdown phase, or we are facing so many problems. And now the awareness about the health care, awareness about the cleanliness, awareness about the social distancing, so many things we are now purposefully, intentionally, through using different media, we are focusing on that. So maximum people nowadays, they are trying to follow that, and that awareness generated. We are using so many different things to avoid such type of infections. You can observe nowadays that some people, they used to visit doctor in intervals. Nowadays that intervals, the frequency, it is decreased because everyone is taking precaution. So that precautions are important. So here author focused on all that things, that self-reliant, everybody should have their self-confidence, self-reliant. We should not depend on others, that somebody else will come and then there will be change. We have to fight for our own rights. Why should we wait for others? Means somebody, the messenger of God or the person will come, and then that person will solve, and we will just wait for the sum. So you create that well-being, the things in your mind, or positivity in your mind. Similarly, here what will happen? Your image, your way of thinking will change. You will get support from so many people when your intention is positive. Here also same thing happened, that when the peasants understood that their champion, means Mahatma Gandhi, he was in problem with the authorities. So many peasants gathered in that village Motihar. Why it happened? Because everybody understood that here the person who is not from that area, he is not native of that area, he is outsider from that area, but he is there to help the peasants, and the authorities, they have done such a task, or they are thinking to take him in the custody, or he would be in the problem. Means then others will understand that your intention is pure, surely they will come with you and your mission will complete. So make that important arrangement and you can have very nice startup. So I would give you best wishes for that, that you start thinking about this, and in future find out such problems which others, especially the poor people, they are facing, and try to solve at least one problem of any village you can select. Go there, do case study or survey of that village, and using your intellect, using your power of gathering the people, convincing power. Or one more thing here, it is negotiation. The leader should have that negotiation skill, and while negotiating, sometime you have to take one step back also, but the benefit should be everlasting, or that endless support everyone should give you. When you will plan that work, when you will understand that work, and then I hope that if one student group will select one village, and consistently they will be back off, or they will get the feedback, or they will take the fall off, then I am sure that that village people will get benefit and everyone will be happy. So one small project also, if you will take, and all the students will also get inspiration from you when you will start up such type of activities. Others will also take inspiration from you. We can take the example of Pani Foundation. In the beginning, very few they join such type of training, but last 2-3 years you can observe that so many villages they joined in that program, and so many celebrities also joined, awareness created, and with the help of villagers, so many villages they have done irrigation projects. So it is possible when any foundation or any trust or any NGO, the group of the students, group of the youngsters, if they will decide to do, then it is possible. And as a citizen, it is everyone's responsibility to take that challenge and go ahead. At least sometime from your busy schedule, you have to take out and help the poor people. So this is very important for our nation growth, economic stability, unity, integrity of the nation, and slowly then we can view, we can visualize vision of what type of vision? Superpower. Understood? India will be superpower when India will have all that things, and the world will also respect the Indians, because we will have very nice rate of literacy, because everyone will think to educate, and when that literacy rate will change, when we will take cooperation from all bureaucrats, everyone will take positive attitude towards the human being, or the especially the poor people, then there would not be the crisis rich and poor, there would not be the gap as like a means rich they are becoming rich and poor they are becoming poor. So there will not be such type of problem will occur. Everyone will have understanding, and that understanding will help each other in various ways. So here I can understand that in this phase the youth can change all things, and our India is the nation of youth. As per the population all statistic, if you will observe, as compared to the other countries, we have the strength, we have power of youth. And I feel, or I would appeal to all the students, that you create a group, or you think in such a way in future after 12th you can set such type of projects and help our nation, help neighboring villages at least. So your work will be recognized, and one day others, so many villages or so many students will be follower of you, like how we are the follower of Mahatma Gandhi or so many national leaders. So we will start discussion about the lesson. In the beginning itself, what is here mentioned, when I first visited Gandhi in 1942 at his ashram in Sevagram. So here ashram, everybody can understand, we are the Indians, so we cannot have any problem of ashram. How is the ashram, that facilities, their rules, regulations, peace, discipline, so many things in ashram culture, means from morning to evening all it is all set up, it is ready, and that discipline, as per the discipline everyone they have to follow the prayer or reading of the scriptures, and peace, or all concerned with the eating habits, so many things, or how to speak, so many etiquettes, manners in that ashram culture they are following. Still some ashram they are following such type of good discipline. So in Sevagram in central India, he said, "I will tell you how it happened that I decided to urge the departure of the British. It was in 1917. So here the infer their meanings in that urge the departure. Here meaning, what would be the meaning of the phrase urge the departure? So here insist on the going away. And to whom? Britishers. We have to insist them to go. And we have to use here, what was the Gandhiji's principle? Non-violence. Using technique of non-violence, using technique of rules and regulation, understanding the situations, or using the technique of telegram. So such type of things Gandhiji used to do. Used to write letters to the government, used to announce such type of things. So with legal way, he used to do the satyagraha, we can understand that word. So such type of things here in the beginning it is mentioned, that I decided to urge the departure of the British. It was in 1917, here reference it is given. He had gone to the December 1916 annual convention of Indian National Congress Party in Lucknow. So here every year such type of conventions were there, and in here it is mentioned the party, Indian National Congress Party, and place is given Lucknow. There were 2,301 delegates and many visitors. So there were so many delegates from different areas, and there would be very nice discussion on raising different issues or problems, and they would discuss, and as per the proceedings of that, they will take all that topics, and then with the motion, against the motion, so many discussions, and then they would take the decisions, and according to that decisions they will go ahead with their plans. So here during the proceedings Gandhi recounted, a peasant came up to me looking like any other peasant in India, poor, emaciated. So here poor everybody can understand, but the word here it is mentioned as a emaciated, means abnormally thin or weak. That person was abnormally thin or weak, especially because of illness or lack of food. So he was poor, as well as other problems were also there. So that we can understand. So here it is specially mentioned, Gandhi recounted, a peasant came up to me looking like any other peasant in India, poor and emaciated, and said, I am Rajkumar Shukla. And what was the name of that peasant? What was the name of that poor person? The name of that poor person is Rajkumar Shukla. I am from Champaran. And here he is stating that Rajkumar Shukla, he was from Champaranya. And I want you to come to me, to my district. So what was the demand? So demand of that person, that he was insisting that Gandhiji should visit that Champaran. Gandhi had never heard of the place. It was in the foothills of the towering Himalayas near the kingdom of Nepal. And here it is said that Gandhiji never visited that place. So here Gandhiji had never heard of that place, that Champaranya place. And one more here, where was that place? It is here mentioned. It was in the foothills of the towering Himalayas near the kingdom of Nepal. So here Nepal, that country is near that kingdom, the place here it is mentioned, and Himalayas area. So geographically you can understand the area, place. So here Rajkumar Shukla, and the then remaining story about that, here the detailed description it is given. In the next passage, under an ancient arrangement, the Champaran peasants were sharecroppers. So here they were the sharecroppers. They used to do the farming using the technique, using the thing as a sharecropper. So here Rajkumar Shukla was one of them. He was illiterate. Again here important thing it is mentioned about the education, that the Rajkumar Shukla, he was illiterate but resolute, but he was determined. He was poor. He was such type of person, here it is mentioned like emaciated, very poor, very thin, because of the, maybe because of the food problem, or maybe because of other also problem. His face, all his appearance, it was looking like that, that he was in need of help. He was one of that person, but some other also aspect here. One aspect it is illiteracy. Second aspect here it is mentioned about, even though he was illiterate, but he was determined. He had come to the Congress session to complain about the injustice of the landlord system in Bihar. So he was there to complain. And suppose somebody is doing injustice with you, you should have that right to raise voice against that person. And that is what the self, your image, why should you do such type of things unnecessarily? Somebody is doing injustice with you and you are just keeping quiet. So this should not happen. The Congress session to complain about the injustice of the landlord system in Bihar, and somebody had probably said, speak to Gandhi. So he might have discussed with some people, so they might have shared that thing, that you can meet the Gandhiji, and if you will speak with Mahatma Gandhi, what will happen? He will surely help you. And when somebody will tell you that this is the person can help, and he was genuine, because he was facing the problem of the injustice and from landlord system in Bihar, and that landlords, they used to harass them, they used to humiliate poor peasants or the sharecroppers. So here it is mentioned that you can go and you can discuss with Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi will surely help you. And here it is mentioned that Congress session, and he was present there to complain about the landlord system in Bihar. So you can understand that suppose the leader like Mahatma Gandhi, he would not be free. Maybe his prior appointments would be there. So how directly he will accept that condition and he will go, and that place is also not so near. But what happened next, we will think. Gandhi told Shukla he had an appointment in Kanpur and was also committed to go to other parts of India. And he had already given commitments that he would go in different parts of the India. Shukla accompanied him everywhere. He was illiterate, but he accompanied everywhere because he was determined. And one more thing, Shukla followed him to the ashram. For weeks, he never left Gandhi's side. So he went to the ashram. Wherever Gandhiji will go, he used to go, because he was determined. And it was his genuine request that you first visit our place, because there are so many sharecroppers and they are living such type of life, which is very dangerous humiliation, and landlords, they are doing such type of things which are not good with the people. So here, fix a date, he begged. So literally here we can understand that here Rajkumar Shukla, he was behaving like he begged literally that you fix a date, because he was determined and anyhow you have to come to our place. So up till this, today we will conclude the next part. In the next video we will discuss. You go through the original lesson, read from beginning to ending, make your own notes, find out words, and think about the philosophy and what we can learn from this lesson, and make notes in a separate way so you can think about the progress of the nation.